Welcome to our weekly roundup of the news around Uganda. I'm Lydia Lekonyero. President Yoweri Museveni has been sworn in for the sixth term as the president of Uganda at Kololo Independence Grounds. Before the president was sworn in, the chairperson of the Electoral Commission, Justice Simon Mugenyi Byabakama, confirmed his victory following the presidential elections, which were held on January 14, 2021.
The current term of the president expires today, Wednesday, 12th of May, 2021. The Electoral Commission, therefore, in fulfillment of the mandate granted to it under Articles 61, Clause 2, and Article 105 of the Constitution, organized, conducted, and held presidential election polls on the 14th of January, 2021. The Electoral Commission thereafter ascertained, published, and declared the results of the presidential elections with candidate Yoweri Museveni Kibuhaburwa Kaguta as the winner.
Museveni was later sworn in by the Chief Justice Alphonse Owindolo.
I, Yoweri Kibuhaburwa Kaguta Museveni, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I will be faithful and bear the true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution. So help me God. I, Yoweri Kibuhaburwa Kaguta Museveni, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I shall faithfully exercise the functions of the President of Uganda and shall uphold, preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution, and observe the laws of Uganda, and that I shall promote the welfare of the people of Uganda. So help me God.
Meanwhile, President Yoweri Museveni has pledged to continue addressing social issues affecting the community and stagnate the economic development of the country. Museveni, who was speaking after swearing in, said top on the agenda in the sixth term is free education for both primary and secondary schools, protection of land owners, fighting corruption, and upgrading feeder roads, among others.
Implementing free education in government primary and secondary schools. That free education must be implemented. Providing free vaccines and therapeutic drugs in government health centers. Protecting Bivanja owners over the iniquitous Mairo land system, ensuring that the feeder roads are in good condition following the provision of good road equipment for all districts, fighting corruption of government officials, including magistrates and the policemen, and dealing decisively with the cattle thieves and those who steal crops from the gardens.
Museveni also said in the next financial year, the government has allocated 464 billion shillings to cater for sectors hit hard by the COVID-19 lockdown. He has, however, added that the lockdown restrictions will be erased following the vaccination of at least 4.8 million people. Still in the news, after intensifying operations on curfew in Kampala metropolitan area, police impounded 1,200 motorcycles and 33 motor vehicles last night. At least 50 suspects were also arrested for failing to comply with the Minister of Health guidelines meant to stop the spread of COVID-19. The Kampala Metropolitan Police Deputy PRO Luke Owoyesigire says most of the motorists will be issued with express penalty scheme fines, while others will be arraigned before the courts of law.
I've impounded 1,200 motorcycles and 33 motor vehicles. 50 suspects were arrested. Investigations are ongoing and the operations are still on.
Still in the news, Muslims from all over the world on Thursday celebrated Eid el-Fitri to mark the end of the holy month of Ramadan. The Mufti of Uganda, Sheikh Shaban Ramadan Mubaje, used the opportunity to request President Yoweri Museveni to pardon all suspects who are detained on charges related to politics. During the campaign ahead of the general elections in January 2021, a number of people were arrested by security and are still detained, pending prosecution in the civil courts and the general court martial.
We call upon His Excellency the President to pardon all those who have been in confinement due to this political situation which has been in the country, that let them be released, let them enjoy the freedom with their families. Some of them are Muslims, they want to enjoy Eid al-Fitr with their families. So we plead to His Excellency the President to pardon these people.
Mubadje also requested President Museveni to order for the release of Boda Boda motorcycles, which were impounded on allegations of flouting curfew time of 6 p.m. In Arua, the Muslims have been encouraged to continue doing good deeds. Saidi Omar Dramani, the director of the Islamic University in Uganda, while leading the Eid prayers at the Arua campus, also thanked the government for protecting freedom of worship as a human right.
The issue is, this was a training for us to start now practicing it after the month of Ramadan, to continue doing the same things, because Ramadan brings you very close to God, and secondly, for the community to appreciate the little that God has given to them. And one of the things that God has given the Muslim community of this country is freedom of worship, and that we need to appreciate, because there are many places out there who do not have that advantage.
Shafiq Shako, a nursing student, congratulated fellow Muslims for completing the fast.
As a response from the preaching, they have advised us about the good way that as a Muslim should patrol, so we avoid bad company, so that we show a good image of Islam to others. So basically, I advise others to continue with the good spirit, to observe the good things that they have been doing in the Ramadan, then to avoid the bad things that they have not been doing.
Salim Chiriga, a Muslim faithful, couldn't hide his joy being able to meet as a group since 2019 due to the pandemic.
Just I feel joy to be back for the Eid prayers, because we lost just spiritually and the unity among ourselves as Muslims during the lockdown. And then for this time, we feel great to be together and then to celebrate Eid al-Fitr together as brothers and sisters. For us as a Muslims, it is very important to go to education, both Islamically and that secular. We need to have the education of everything so that we cope up with our life and the hereafter.
Still on the same subject, President Yoweri Museveni has congratulated the Muslim community in Uganda upon completing the holy month of Ramadan. In his message posted on Twitter, the president also urged Muslims to continue with the virtues of charity and good deeds, as it has been the practice during the month of fasting. The president's message comes a day after he took oath of office to serve for a sixth term as the president of Uganda. We have updates on COVID-19. Uganda has confirmed 60 new cases of COVID-19, according to an update from the Ministry of Health. The update also revealed that the cumulative confirmed cases are now 42,487. According to the ministry, the confirmed new cases are from tests done on May 10th from 3,056 samples. Masaka had the highest number of cases at 22, followed by Kampala at 19, Rubirizi 8, Adjumani 4, Tororo 2, Wakiso 1, Jinja 1, Kalungu 2, Otuhe 1, and Kotido 1. The development comes after Uganda registered an 81% increase in the number of COVID-19 cases within a period of 1 month, which is raising fears of a second wave. As a result, the country has slapped a travel ban on countries with very high infections, leveled as Category 1. By the time of filing this report, only India was in this category. For countries in Category 2, the government has instituted a raft of measures, including subjecting travelers from those countries to a COVID-19 test. Those found to be positive are sent into isolation centers at their cost. According to the health ministry, the measure is in a bid to avoid importation of deadlier foreign variants. Category 2 countries include Kenya, South Africa, South Sudan, Ethiopia, United Kingdom, the US, UAE, and Turkey. Meanwhile, the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, has revealed that the 10th Parliament will officially end its duties this week. Kadaga, during her communication to Parliament, informed members of Parliament that they had planned to hold Parliament sittings the whole of this week, but due to the two public holidays, including the swearing-in ceremony of President Yoweri Museveni, they will only hold 3 sittings. When the 10th Parliament finalizes its work this week, the members of Parliament elect for the 11th Parliament will start swearing in from Monday 17th May to Thursday 20th May.
Week of the plenary of the 10th Parliament, but the week will be interrupted by 2 events. One with the inauguration of His Excellency the President, which will be a public holiday, but also the likelihood of Eid al-Fitr. So, in effect, we have only 3 sitting days to complete our urgent work of the 10th Parliament. So I just want to urge you to apply yourselves to the task so that we can discharge our obligations.
Kadaga earlier cautioned members of parliament of the 11th parliament against money lenders. She asked them to improvise with the money they get from parliament.
The money lenders have offices around here, so they have been sending messages to members that I can get you 1 billion in 3 days. So if you are a new member who has just come from election, maybe you borrowed money, you are in debt, then you hear 1 billion in 3 days, you might go for it. But for me, that is the biggest message. I don't want anyone to touch loans until August. First, I want them to know how much money are you getting in a month, how much money do you need for rent, how much money do you need for school fees, how much run your constituency, and also do you actually need the loan or you can live on the money you earn here.
Still in the news, Water and Environment Minister Sam Cheptoris has warned against increased water tariffs to the consumers. Minister Cheptoris noted that water is sold to the vendors by the national supplier at a very low cost, and therefore there is no justification for increased tariffs to the consumers. Cheptoris warned that they would be pushed out of the chain if they did not restrain their acts. He was making a presentation of his ministry's performance during this ending NRM government tenure at the OPM in Kampala.
Most of our areas in Kampala here, Salam, should be paying 50 shillings a jerrycan, because National Water sells the person who is selling, the vendor, the person operating these public stand pipes, sells to them at 25 shillings. Now you, the vendor, you sell to the customers at 50 shillings, a jerrycan. Because water is a human right. Water is a human right. Everybody must have access to some water. In fact, in other countries, even when you fail to pay your bill, they give you a little to make you survive.
Meanwhile, the building sitting Bundibugyo District Headquarters caught fire last week in the morning. It all started when smoke came out of the building from the roof, and on reaching the site, the fire had consumed the Central Registry's office. Police officers from Bundibugyo Police Station reached in time with fire extinguishers but could not do much. According to the newly elected councillor, Francis Balikamya, there are mixed reactions from the public doubting the outgoing chairperson LC5 Ronald Mutegeki, since his handover was not clear as he tried some resistance. Agri Okumu, the district police commander, said they managed to break the locked doors to save what they could, and there is no dead person reported yet, though a few of the properties were burnt down. He thanked the community members who participated in putting out the fire as investigations continue. Still in the news, the visiting Sheikh of Uganda Muslim Council, Sheikh Ismail Mutebi, has called on President Yoweri Museveni to consider appointing more Muslims in his new cabinet. Sheikh Mutebi, who was the lead preacher at Ajib Mosque in Soroti City East, made the remarks a day after President Museveni's swearing-in that marked the beginning of his new term. Sheikh Mutebi also cautioned the Muslims against smoking, saying smokers shall not go to heaven. He also emphasized the need for them to educate their children.
I will thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has enabled us to reach on this day, alhamdulillah. May he accept our first, alhamdulillah. Our message to all community of Muslims is all about they must not be engaged in things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want. Another thing which I talked about in my kutuba was about requesting the government to also put some Muslims in the cabinet, because we are lacking Muslims in the cabinet. As this is a new government, inshallah, a new cabinet, we expect also us Muslims to have new faces who are Muslims, inshallah. And we have also encouraged Muslims to educate their children, because today, as you are seeing, the world is keeping on changing, needs educated what? People.
The Muslim faithfuls welcomed his message and promised to follow suit. Gulu Regional Referral Hospital is overwhelmed with the number of patients seeking post-abortion care. The hospital has so far registered 1,288 cases from January 2020 to April 2021. Christine Akidi, the nursing officer in charge of the gynecological ward at the hospital, says the number is worrying. They are now planning for community sensitization on the matter. Akidi says in just the last 11 days, the hospital has registered 37 cases. She said contributing factors include malaria in pregnancy, incompetent cervix, babies not lying in the uterus, molar pregnancy, and frequent childbearing. She says some of them are referred from other health facilities after losing a lot of blood.
Knowing very well that already they have underlying condition, they end up also coming late at night. When this condition started long ago, you believe that even if a doctor, a midwife is still handling a patient, should leave that patient and come and help you. That is the belief, the perception which the community has for us. They also believe that when they come in Gulu, regional referral hospital, government hospital, everything is at hand. Food is there, tea is there.
And with that story, we come to the end of our weekly news roundup. Good day.